Next is profitability index. This is the fifth technique. Profitability index is the fifth technique used in your capital budgeting techniques. So what is this profitability index? Index means a number which doesn't carry any units like kilograms or numbers or meters, kilometers, nothing. It's an index number which shows you the performance of something. So profitability index is a number which shows the performance of your project, which shows the project's profitability. Yes, we consider it as one. We consider a profitability index as one. That is your cost as one. And if you get something more than one, if your profitability index is more than one, means that says that you are having a profitability. And if you get less than one, means it says that you don't even get the cost. And if it is equivalent to one, means it says that you are achieving your cost. That is, there is no profit, no loss. So that's a profitability index. It's a number like your Sensex, like your Nifty. It has a performance numbers, right? So just like that, profitability index is a performance number which shows your profitability performance, profit performance, right? And the formula for profitability index, PI, in short we call it as PI, profitability index, PI. Formula is, here also we have a formula, present value of cash inflow divided by cash outflow. Right, this is a formula to find out the profitability index. Present value of cash inflow by cash outflow, that is CO. This is a formula to find out the profitability index, and the formula will change based on the type of cash flow. For example, if it is a lump sum cash flow, cash inflow is lump sum. So present value of cash inflow is lump sum, means you have to use the present value of lump sum formula. That makes profitability index is equal to F divided by 1 plus I the whole power n, the whole divided by cash outflow. Okay, or present value of lump sum formula. And if it is annuity, the cash flow is annuity, annuity cash inflow. That means the amount which flows every year is constant. Then the formula will be profitability index is equal to A into 1 by I minus 1 divided by I into 1 plus I the whole power n divided by C. This is for annuity cash inflow. The cash inflow is lump sum, uneven cash inflow. That means the cash which flows inside is not equal, but it happens every year. In that situation, the formula is profitability index is equal to the uneven cash flow. Summation T is equal to 1 to N AT divided by 1 plus I the whole power T, the whole divided by cash outflow. So don't think there is three formulas. You have three types of formulas based on the present value of your cash inflow. If the cash inflow, how it is. If it is lump sum, the formula is present value of cash lump sum. And if it is annuity, the present value of annuity inflow. And uneven, present value of uneven inflow. You cannot apply all these three formulas into one type of cash flow, right? Based on the type of cash flow, you have to apply the formula. And the standard formula is present value of cash inflow by cash outflow. Okay? So now, acceptance rule. So, we have discussed the profitability index and the formula of profitability index. Now, we are going to see the acceptance rule of the profitability index, that is acceptance rule, right? So in the acceptance rule, we have three types of acceptance rule, that is accept the project, when, how will you accept it? When profitability index, as I told you, if it is equivalent to 1 means you are in no profit, no loss. If it is greater than 1 means you are in profit, less than 1 means you are in loss. So accept it when the profitability index is greater than 1. Because when you calculate a profitability index of a project, you will get an answer 1, less than 1 or greater than 1. So if you are getting it greater than 1 means accept it. Reject the project when profitability index is less than 1. Okay. Third, may accept or reject when PE is equivalent to 1. This is the acceptance rules of profitability index. You may accept, you will accept when the profitability index is greater than 1. You will reject when it is less than 1. You may accept or reject when it is equal to 1. Okay. Now, let us discuss one problem. There is a situation in which the initial cash outflow of a project is 1 lakh. Cash outflow, investment is 1 lakh. And it can generate a cash inflow of 40,000, 30,000, 50,000 and 20,000 in 4 years. That is every year for 4 years. 10% is the discount rate and you are asked to find out the profitability index. So it's a project whose cash outflow is 1 lakh and it will generate an inflow of 40,000 in the first year, 30,000 in the second year, 50,000 in the third year and 20,000 in the fourth year. And you have a 10% discount rate and you are asked to find out the profitability index. So, cash outflow 1 lakh. Cash inflow 40,000, 30,000, 50,000 and 20,000. Number of years is 4 and the discount rate is 10%. Now you are asked to find out the profitability index. So the formula for profitability index is PI is equal to present value of cash inflow by cash outflow. Okay. So here inflow is of what type? It's an uneven cash flow, right? Because 40,000 in the first year, 30 in the second, 50 in the third and 20 in the last. And if it is a lump sum, means it the inflow will not happen every year. It may happen only at the end of the year. For example, only 20,000. If it is annuity, means every year same amount. 40,000 is annuity. Now it is uneven cash flow. So you have to use the formula of summation T is equal to 1 to N AT by 1 plus I the whole power T divided by cash outflow. Okay. Now we are going to apply the variables into the formula. So first year is 40,000. 40,000 divided by 1 plus I is 10% is the interest rate. So it's 1 plus 10% the whole power is 1. Second year plus 30,000 divided by 1 plus 10% the whole square plus 50,000 divided by 1 plus 10% the whole cube plus 20,000 plus by 1 plus 10% the whole power 4 divided by cash outflow is 1 lakh. Okay, the formula becomes like this. And when you substitute, you're going to substitute this. So profitability index is equal to 40,000 divided by 1 plus 10% is 40,000 divided by 1.10 plus 30,000 divided by 1.21 plus 50,000 divided by 1.331 plus 20,000 divided by 1.4641 4641 the whole divided by 1 lakh. When you substitute this, you will get 36363.36 plus 24793.38 24793.38 plus 37565.74 37565.74 plus 3660.06 1360.26 the whole, that is after substituting all these things, divided by 1 lakh. Okay, then you will get profitability index is equal to, after summing up all those things, you can round it up to 112383.01 divided by 1 lakh, and your profitability index will be 1.12. Okay, so profitability index is 1.12. Not percentage, not kilograms, not rupees, it's an index. So the profitability index is 1.12. So you can accept the project because it is more than one. So what has happened? I will explain once again. You have a project whose initial cash outflow is 1 lakh and it will generate a cash inflow every year. That is, in the first year it will generate 40,000, the second year 30,000, the third year is 50,000, the fourth year is 20,000, and you have an interest rate of 10%, and you are asked to find the profitability index, and the formula for profitability index is present value of cash inflow by the cash outflow. Here the cash inflow is an uneven cash flow, so we are using the formula of present value of uneven cash flow, and the formula is summation t equal to 1 to n AT by 1 plus I the whole power T divided by cash outflow. Cash outflow is here 1 lakh, we all know. And we are substituting all these things and we are arriving at a value of 1.12. That's what your profitability index. And the profitability index is more than 1 and we are accepting the project. That's the acceptance rules. So by this, the profitability index is over.